Hey, Most Amazing Top 10 family, I'm your host, Trey Durana, and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I thought after the first video, you guys would have learned that you shouldn't be digging around in the trash because there's literally nothing good in there. Well, maybe there is. Maybe there's a story of someone finding like $1 million and getting it to change their life, and then they were never the same again, and they only had the garbage to thank. But that's not what you're here for. You're here to see some horrible things that people found in the garbage. And that's why I'm bringing you today's list of top 10 scary items found in the trash part 2. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Also, stick around for the whole video because I'm gonna be doing some more pet shoutouts, which you guys love so much. If you want me to shout out your pet, remember you can hit me up on Instagram. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. At number 10, we have veterans' grave markers. You think being in World War I and World War II would gain you an undying level of respect from everyone ever? Well, depending on what side of the war you're fighting on, obviously. Well, someone who works as a waste disposal worker said that they found a bunch of old World War II grave markers and medals in the trash. He said he was shocked to find them and that he had to look them up to make sure that they were real, and sure enough, they were legit. This put him in a strange situation. What do you do with old war memorabilia that you find in the trash? It's not yours, but it's very hard to find who these belong to. I mean, you could sell them on the internet, but I feel like that would give you more bad mojo than pushing a toddler into a pile of mud right after you steal his Nintendo Switch. Well, he didn't try to steal them. He called the police because that seemed like the most logical thing to do, and then the police took care of it from there. You either give it to them or a museum. Like, I don't know who you leave it with, really. Well. At number 9, we have ransom notes. One of the hardest parts about finding something potentially dangerous in the trash is that it is very hard to track down the person that it belongs to. All the garbage gets mixed up together, and it's not like there's a tracking device that comes in each bag that goes into the truck. But one garbage man found something that sent him on a little bit of a goose chase. He found what looked like to be drafts of ransom notes. At first, he figured that they were just a joke, but when he went back on the following week on the same route, he noticed that there was the same notes in the back of the truck. So this is obviously freaky. It seemed like there was a kidnapper in training waiting to find for the perfect victim to throw in the back of a painter van. I just picture him walking around his apartment brainstorming the perfect letter to send out. This garbage man grabbed a few of them, then turned them over to the police. It's unknown whether or not they were ever tracked back to the person, but the garbage man said he never saw the notes again. At number 8, we have rotted milk. Now, if you're thinking just a single 4-liter jug of milk, how bad could that be? Well, that's not what I'm talking about at all. I'm talking about what a lot of schools will do. Schools are apparently one of the worst places for a garbage man to visit because of this reason. Every time a school has a massive flat of milk cartons that expire, they throw them right into the garbage. Now, that much milk mixing in the blazing heat of summer, and now you have a giant vat of rotting dairy sitting outside in the heat for sometimes up to a week. A garbage man will pull the lid off and get slapped in the face with a fog of rotted milk stench and millions of flies that have just been feeding on that milk, all while trying not to let this very heavy thing of liquid splash on them while they throw it into the back of a truck. I understand why garbage men go on strike. I don't know if there's an amount of money you can pay me to do that. At number 7, we have a bunch of money. Well, it's kind of funny we roll from money into that one. Yeah, you know. Why would this be on the list of scary things? Finding a bunch of money in a garbage truck seems like the definition of one man's trash is another man's treasure. Getting a big payday like that, you could use it for anything you want, and you don't even need to know who the money belongs to. And that's what the scary part is. It could be bad people. What if they're the kind of people who come and find who took their money and then put a bunch of holes in you for taking it? Yeah, you don't want to end up on the wrong side of those people. This is exactly what a garbage man from Wisconsin thought when he found $20K in cash tucked away in a duffel bag. And for a moment, he thought of all the things he could buy with $20K. Probably a nice payment on a home, or maybe he could throw it all into the stock market and turn that 20 into 100. But then he thought about who would be walking around with $20K in cash in a bag, and he didn't want to get on the wrong side, so he left it where he found it. It's unknown what happened to all that money, but he reported that when he went back to the same spot the following week, the money was gone. At number 6, we have 2-for-1. Sometimes you'll find things that are so strange, they will really make you wonder what people are doing in their free time. Like when a waste disposal worker found a baby carriage with a taxidermied raccoon and alligator sitting side by side inside of it. I don't even know what that means. It's like the weirdest display of affection I've ever heard of, and I can only imagine what it's like on the inside of that person's house. If that's what they're throwing away, what's the good stuff like? At number 5, we have rabid animals. When you pull back the lid on a garbage can, you can expect to find garbage. Like when you swipe right on my Tinder profile. But every now and again, there's something alive in there looking back at you. Most of the time, it's a raccoon or possum, and the two of you just have a standoff, and both parties are like backing away slowly, letting everything settle down nice and slow. But if you're one of the unlucky ones, then sometimes you can throw back the lid and it will reveal a fully rabid animal that is ready to tear you apart because its brain has been torn apart by a horrible disease. Yeah, picture that. You open up a can and then a family of rabid raccoons chase you down the street and you can't slow down because if you do, they'll bite you and then kill you. Well, I think you can understand why that would be terrifying. At number four, we have a skinned face. Let's stay on the animal kick for the number four spot. Something that you quickly learn as a waste disposal worker is that people have no limits in what they're willing to throw away into the trash. They really want to put every last thing in the garbage and just forget about it and just let all these things leave a mark on your pretty little brain. Like a skinned sheep's head. You're expecting to see some apple cores, maybe at the worst some toilet paper with a little bit of poo on it, but you're not expecting to see a face that has been skinned like it's been popped right out of a Rob Zombie movie. And when it's right in front of you, it's already too late to close your eyes. Every time I go into a butcher shop and they have animals with the face still on it, it kind of just creeps me out. I'm like, ugh, could you imagine that being surprised on you? And imagine if you were vegan. That would probably ruin your week. Yeah, I don't think you want to see those kind of things. At number three, we have sex toys. Ooh. This is not to shame anyone. You do whatever you want with your bodies as long as you're not hurting anyone else. All your kinks are your business. I don't care. But looking at it from the perspective of a person who has to handle these things, I understand why they would not only be scary, but also very gross. It's fun sharing those things with someone you like, not touching the ones from someone who threw them away in the trash and you don't even know them. Not only will waste disposal workers often find all sorts of sex toys in the garbage, but they will either find large amounts of them, literally boxes full of them. That's someone literally throwing away a box of fun. The workers suspect they must have been some sort of porn office inside the building. That's why they're throwing away so many sex toys. But much worse than that is some people will throw away soiled sex toys. Yeah, they still have all sorts of body fluids on them. Just thinking about this makes me gag a little. Ugh. Like, think about it. You would have to touch that. No thanks. At number two, we have do not open. Something quite common that happens with garbage men is that they will find boxes or bags or containers that are labeled do not open. If you see something like this, you might think, oh, I have to open it. What if there's something dangerous in there? Or a body part, something that could be linked to a crime? Well, I'm here to tell you that it almost never is. If you're going to get rid of body parts, you don't write do not open on the box. That's a little too obvious. It's more often than not a dead pet. The worst case was a chest freezer that was brought to the dump by a couple of brothers. They had taped it closed with duct tape and wrote do not open on the lid, but one of the garbage men insisted that they should take a look inside. Well, let me tell you that the smell alone was so bad it made a garbage man throw up. It takes a hell of a lot to make someone like that puke. What was in this chest freezer? Well, the freezer got disconnected from power and 40 pounds of halibut just sat in it for 4 days in the middle of summer. It's safe to say that the smell was toxic. And for the number one spot, we have computer files. This one was written on Reddit by a Reddit user, Sulco42. He said that he found a computer that was pretty high powered just sitting in the trash. He knows a thing or two about PCs, so he decided to take it home and poke around inside to see what he could find. At first, it was some pretty normal documents, but then he came across something extremely disturbing. The computer was packed full of child porn. He immediately took it over to the police. On the bright side, the police were able to take the computer and connect it to several other people, and a series of arrests happens, and a bunch of sick people were behind bars because one guy thought it was a good idea to snoop around a computer. All right, everyone, that is our list, and as promised, I'm going to be doing some more pet shoutouts. Remember, if you want me to shout out your pet, you can message me on Instagram. I pick new pets every day, so if you don't get picked one day, message back another day. If it takes me a little while to get back to you, I am sorry, I have a lot of these to do. And without taking any longer, let's shout out some pets. First, we have Jenna's cat family. That many cats in one picture, there is so much snuggling to be had. Cat sent in a picture of her cat. That's a sleepy cat, he's ready for a snooze. Stevie sent in her sleek black cat. Look at how nice that boy looks. Very nice, very nice, very sleek. Alexis sent in her cat Snow. That white fur is looking sharp. Then Jack sent in a picture of Moo Moo. Dogs with hats always look like they're the most important person in the room. And finally, we have the dog Emily. Look at how cute that doggo is with the big floof on top of the head. Love it. All right, everyone, that has been our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I've been Chayne Arana, and I guess you can kind of do good if you dig around in the trash. So go do it, I guess. I don't know. Bye.